Good morning. Today we will take the discussion. We will learn about the loss of energy during the combination. We come to know how the energy will lost during the combination of the capacitor. So the topic is loss of energy in combination of the capacitor. We know the combination, one is the parallel and the series, and on that case we have calculated the capacitance, equivalent capacitance for either of the cases. And we come to know that in case of the parallel combination, the capacitance will increase. Now, what about the energy? So, on that case, just see, we know that the energy have the formula, or we can express the energy in three ways, that is the U is equal to half Cv square, or half Q square by the C, or half QV. Half QV. So these are the method by which we calculate the energy. More things we know that in case of the capacitance, C is equal to what here? It is the Q by V. Or this implies that V is equal to Q by C. That is the relation, another relation, which we will see here. Now, let's suppose there is the two capacitor of difference capacitance. Suppose two capacitor of capacitance C1 and C2. Capacitance C1 and C2. With their potential V1 and V2 respectively. And by the figure we understand that these two capacitor 1 of capacitance C1 and potential of V1. Like that, another capacitor of that is the second of potential V2 of capacitance of C2. Both have the different energy according to the formula. We can get for capacitor 1, energy is equal to U1 is equal to what it is, half C1 V1 square, and that let it be the equation number 1 or relation number 1. Now for capacitor 2, that is the U2 is equal to half C2 V2 square, and that is the relation number 2. Individually, they have the energy. That energy is the U1 half C1 V1 square and half C2 V2 square. Now, whenever we combine these two, what our choice of combination? For that, just see, if we take the series, or if we take the parallel, which one is the better option to combine the capacitor? That in series, we know that the capacitance decreases. And in parallel, it increases. That means, for the formula half Cv square, that energy is related to the capacitance, directly to that of the capacitance. So, on that case, our better choice to make a combination with the parallel. Now, for that parallel combination, we get this one. For that parallel combination, during the combination, during the combination, that is, we have the two capacitors when combined together. One capacitor and another capacitor. It is combined in parallel. Capacitor 1, capacitor 2. Now, here is the one relation which is different. Because in parallel combination, it must have the common potential. Or the potential is same for both this one. But here the potential is V1 and here the potential is V2. So there is the potential difference between the combination, between the two capacitor. So that potential difference means whenever there is a potential difference, some charge will flow. And that charge will flow, that means there is the work done. And that amount of work is, or the work in the form of energy is lost during the combination. So, this is the reason also for the loss of energy. This is the reason for the loss of energy. That is, the flow of the charge to make the potential common. Now, let's suppose during the individual capacitor V1, C1 and the another one is the capacitor V2, C2. Individually, what we observe here, let's suppose it has the energy of the 50 joule. And here also the energy for U1, for U2 is equal to 50 joule. So, whenever individually we see or we combine, we make a sum, we will get the 100 joule of energy. But when we combine it, we will find it is not the 100 joule, some amount of energy is lost, and that loss of energy only due to the work done to move the charge, and that amount of energy is reduced, and that is the loss of energy. Got the point? Now, how it is so? For that, the common potential which we have seen in this combination, the common potential, the common potential in the combination, that common potential is the V, and that V is equal to Q by C. Earlier we have written the formula that V is equal to Q by C, that Q is the total charge and C is the capacitance, total capacitance. Now the net capacitance or equivalent capacitance in the combination, parallel combination, that C is equal to C1 plus C2, and the equivalent net charge in the combination is what it is, that Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2, and we have only the capacitance and the potential. On that case, we will write in place of the Q1, that is the C1 V1, in place of the Q2, that is the C2 V2. Now, the common potential which appears like this, the potential, this, the above equation, let it be the equation number 3. Now, equation 3 becomes, that means here potential V is equal to, in place of the Q, we will write the C1 V1 plus C2 V2 by here, in case of the capacitance, it is C1 plus plus C2. That become the common potential. So the energy stored during this combination is written as the energy stored, the energy stored in the combination that energy is equal to, let in case of the combination earlier it was the individual and sum total of the energy, and here we will write the final energy during the combination, that final is equal to half Cb square. So in place of the C and V square, the potential common, that is equal to, in that become the half, in place of the C it is the C1 plus C2, and there the potential that we will write here C1 C2 plus C1 V1 plus C2 V2 and by C1 plus C2, that of square, that is the energy commonly that during the combination. So the energy, final energy we will write like this, that is the U final is equal to what we have half, and now just solve this one, we have the relation, that is C1 plus C2, here it is the relation here, for squaring this one we have C1 square V1 square plus C2 square V2 square plus, again here it is what, 2C1 C2 V1 V2 by, in the denominator that is the C1 plus C2 whole square. Now one term is here, it has the order of 1 and it has the order of 2. So on that case this relation will cancel, one term will cancel on, and we have the relation U final is equal to half, and that is the C1 square V1 square plus C2 square V2 square plus 2 C1 C2 V1 V2 by C1 plus C2. And now this is the relation number 4, that become the relation number 4. During the combination we will get the energy, and that is the final energy. What was the initial energy? Initial energy we will see that during individual combination of the energy. Now the initial energy, about the initial energy, energy of individual or sum of the individual or of sum of the individual energy, sum of the individual energy, that is U initial I is equal to, that is the half C1 V1 square plus half C2 V2 square. So that relation become the 5. Now energy loss during the combination, what we observe here, if the energy loss, that means the difference of the two energy, initial to the final, let's suppose initial to the final, and that will give the positive or will give the negative value. If it will give the positive value, that means initial energy was the greater than that of the final energy. If it will give the negative value, that means that final energy that is greater than that of the initial one. Now we will see which is the, either it is positive or negative. For that, the loss of energy here, the loss of energy, loss of energy, that is U initial minus U final. Energy is equal to U initial minus U final. Whether it is positive or negative, we will see. So energy U initial minus U final, that is equal to here the relation for the initial, let it be the for initial half C1 V1 square plus half C2 V2 square minus of this relation half, here we will write C1 C1 square V1 square plus CT square V2 square plus here it is 2 C1 C2 V1 V2 by the relation we have C1 plus C2. Now in this particular, half is common in each of the term, and we take the LCM of these two also. So we have the loss of energy U initial minus U final, that is equal to what it is, half we will take out on that case, that is the half, and now this relation with this one C1 V1 square into C1 plus C2 plus C2 V2 square, here it is C1 plus C2, and my by this relation and this one also minus of C1 square V1 square plus again minus minus plus minus, that is C2 square V2 square minus 2 C1 C2 V1 V2, and all this by the C1 plus C2. Now C1 here, on that case C1 square V1 square, that cancels out. Like that here also. So one more we will do the step. That step is the C1 square V1 square plus C1 C2 V1 square. And likewise here also C1 V C2 V2 square plus C2 square V2 square minus, here it is C1 square V1 square minus C2 square V2 square minus 2 C1 C2 V1 V2 by again here C1 plus C2. Now what we observe here, that in this relation we cancel the C1 V1 square. Here also C1 square V1 square, one is positive, another is negative, and here C2 square V2 square, that is also cancelled. Now what are the common we will take out, that is the half, here it is C1 C2 by, that is the C1 plus C2. Now look here, that means here it is relation V1 square plus V2 square minus 2V1 V2. So that relation we have, that is the half C1 C2, here that become the V minus V1 minus V2 whole square by C1 plus C2. That become the relation here, that is the C1 C2 V1 minus V2 whole square by C1 plus twice of the C1 plus C2. and that become the equation number 5. And this equation represent the loss of energy, that is the U initial minus U final. Now we come to know that the combination of all these are the positive, means the whatever we will find here, that the U initial is greater than that of the U final. This relation is the positive one. So we come to the conclusion, the sum total of the capacitor is positive, the product of the capacitor is positive, and potential difference, that is the common, is positive. So all the character is positive. So in that case, the difference initially, individually, the capacitor has the greater energy, but whenever we combine either of the cases, the energy lost. The reason is what? That is the, here we will we understand that to make a common potential among the combination, on that case some of the charge will move. The work done on the charge to move, that amount of work done will what happen? Reduced by the energy, and that is the loss of energy. Now next class we will see the some problems related with the loss of energy. Okay.